yourself.
Ken Ferrari is starting to hit a little bit more of a power spike, but he's still 10 CS behind. His innocence will now be gone on. Doesn't have the shield available. Great flame break. Actually pushes him back. And as K1, who's able to spill the first blood against Ehome, Wisp will be in trouble. He rotated up, but these Chain Suns fought 3-0 with the Pulse Nova. He'll have more than enough damage to get through Whisper.
Yep.
Really well done, but no, maybe not. Back off. Now the 4-3-0 is rotated in. Ferrari wants to find his own kill. They'll focus onto the Grimstroke with the miscoils, the slows. He cannot dodge the Split Earth.
Yep. But you have the benefit of juking those common sentries bottom, stun out of the bat.
Yeah, he's in a lot of trouble. With the flame break, maybe enough space is being created. He's got a salve available. You need to pop it quickly if he was going to live through that last attack.
Immediately.
Yeah.
And now they're going to hunt Meepo on the side, Doom out.
Yeah, they're TPing in towards the mid. There's more coming along. So with Meepo being doomed up, at least the other Meepos can continue the fight.
Where's
they're sold out together. And yeah, well, the damage needs to arrive. Batrider's going to get in here too. But here's CK. He'll find his kill. It is a one for one trade off. Grimstroke for the Abaddon. Yeah. The Barra Strike from SK. The control is just way too much from Ehome. And with the end of the Exism, not only.
Embrace. It's not like he's doing much damage. They don't have any synergy yet.
Ooh.
And Bat is level 3.
That's a really good hit over on Zinkyu. He had no idea he's underneath the sentry.
Find a move, and that's exactly what they're going to do, and there's a Meepo just in front of them.
Yep, SK going to Barra Strike forward to begin with, and that will be one
really
very dead Grimstroke underneath the Shrine. The Doom Gun on the Darkseer, but there's your big double stun, combining with the Soul Mine. Now Meepo, how much damage can you do before 3-0? What a huge split up! Meepo can't do anything. The Pulse Nova's doing all the work in the back lines. Even underneath Shrine, Ehome. CK at least has stuns he can combo with the rest of his team. 4-3-0 is in a little bit of trouble, being backed back into the wall. Earthbind will hold him in place, and well, you're Chris Brown, he's coming in with everybody.
Yep, the Surge on the Meepo.
He's the only one that dies, they're okay. But Yule Scepter up, down he'll come. Starts his runaway as support was there from CK, and yeah, with the Tranquils, somebody please actually attack this Batrider into the trees. Now Firefly will finally run out. Another Spirit Siphon and Stinger still surviving, but wasting so much time. There.
This could open up Roche though, just because the Grimstroke's so close to the pit. But he does have buyback this time. Yes, he
does. Once again. Yule Scepter down, silence, but hey, that's where you got Firefly for. Oh, he began the TP. Didn't realize that Zinkyu is in range. Cannot outrun, so Ehome will be able to surge him forward. They're going to start off. Okay, not the greatest chaining stuns of all, and this may cause some problems, but maybe it won't.
Nice
not when
back.
You got a back wall in that narrow, narrow choke point. More stuns coming out. This one's straight behind, and Zinkyu with the epicenter is good slow, but not enough damage output. It's still going to be a kill. Going the way with now finally Innocence going down. Faith Beyond will follow through. The CK's got all the damage he needs. Abaddon's already bought back, trying to fight. There's a big silence, and they bring in the exit. Oh, with Reality Rift and the stun. They're looking for the bonus damage. The E-Blade will connect over on the Doom, slowing him down. Remember these Reality Rifts, there's such a low cooldown timer. We'll lose Zinkyu off screen as Innocence still looking to back up, but they're waiting it. It's the borrow time. Pull him back in. And the synergy with the CK and the Grimstroke up. Zinkyu's gonna walk into it, looking for a Firestar target. The Hex instantly being popped off. Faith Beyond, the fact they hit the three man with the two man's arms as well. Stuck inside the wall. They've got nowhere to go. Faith Beyond can get himself a good stun off. And he got the Doom over on Darkseer. SK's already gone down. He'll buy back, but now you'll start to see Exism do its work. Chris in the back lines. The stun 4-3-0. Man, they gotta kill this guy. The Pulse Nova was just ripping through the Meepo. He's looking for some more control, but he cannot survive. The Aegis Immortal, it is gonna burn. Now CK with his BKB wants to fight. He'll find Zinkyu. He'll Barra Strike again. This will be a dieback from him as Meepo returns for his second round, but they're still battling into the Exism. The Hex on the lower, they're looking at the target over on Innocence, but Faith Beyond, these never-ending AoE stuns, but Chris, he's got to get out. He's so low. The E-Blade pop, Faith Beyond can't connect onto him, and he stuns and facts him away from the Meepo. Protect this Meepo at all costs. Whisper is doing his job, and they can turn their attention to the big beast. It is Never-End to bring down this Death Prophet and then force the lane. You know they want more, and you know they're gonna get more. The 3 second stun. And Ambergos are there doing it.
So much expense
on bottom, looking for their fight. Zinkyu's able to get the burrow, but the top is going once again. The tier 3 talents are under attack. Ehome have to look behind. They're already signed the TP out from Zinkyu, and this will buy the space for Whisper to try and surge himself away. The Yules will cancel it, so Whisper will still go down. And he's dead for a pretty long time, but it's done, and Ferrari begins his TP in as well. Looking for a target, but this means CK turns around. The Hex was so quick, and a 4 second stun. They're just lacquering it on top, and the back. SK will take that. He'll come in with the epicenter, but the damage is almost nothing. Ehome is fighting,
guys.
And they don't have buybacks. Did they just lose the game? And Vigosa are going to just go for it. And here we go. CK search him in, put the Iron Shell, pull him back in. And the Soul Bind with the Chaining Stun. It's going to be a 1-1 trade-off here. Never end, at least with the BKB. He's able to survive a little
They're
bit longer.
Fighting.
Meepo's just using the physical damage to do the work. Have they got another lockdown? Yep, into Innocence. Pop that LOA. And now full retreat. Don't force the issue. The Burrow Strike CQ. It may as well be a Ravage. He's got everything. Meepo needs some distance. You'll set the up. At least the E-Blade's going to stop the Doom from attacking in. But Neverend's got the damage output right behind him. Himself and yep,
he's got a
BKB
on Pat.
Yeah, he, well, this should be a hard fight, or maybe it won't be. Not when you get the chain suns off, you'll never get the BKB off. But the Soulbind attack through the rear, Batrider's already gonna buy back as well. And they're fighting underneath this wall, backed back in once again. Never end, does not have the damage output. CK's just got all the strength in the world as they look for the extra control. Another stun, another pullback. Oh my god,
the heart.
Now the Chaining Hex, they just want to kill him off before anything can happen. Doom at least gets a wall stomp to happen, and
DP.
The Chaining Silence, and the Fact, and the Lasso. Everyone's being pulled back in this one. Stinger will go down, 70 seconds on the sideline, and the Burrow Strike. Zinq's just forever getting these huge chain stuns, and combining with the Epicenter, the damage output. Chris is so low, he's going to go down as well. Have they pushed too far? Have you bought off more than you can chew?
No.
It is the burger you cannot digest, and even the Grimstroke trying to save his teammate. I'll be very happy to bottle and take that one. And
he's got the level 20 talent.
They know. I think they just caught a small glimpse. Yeah, the Observer Ward just got taken out. So CK with that heart, he's looking at Roshan, the Darkseer. He'll create already the illusions. He sees inside the pit for the moment. A Fact doesn't pull him back into the wall, however, does create some problems. Reality Rip with a stun. A Baton's already gone down. They can move over with a buyback from Meepo. They're coming into fight. 4-3-0, the first target. They're going to proof all on top of him with a Burrow Strike. Zinq, my god, this guy is so good. Forever creating the space. He'll have to sacrifice his life. No, it's actually 4-3-0 who will eventually
Meepo
go down.
So
and with the lasso,
Meepo
is able to back out with 30 HP. The Crypt Swarm, it doesn't manage to connect. Innocence will fall. Never End will probably join him sometime soon. It's a triple kill for K1. Into the pit you go once more. But the tier 4 towers are slow. And they will push for more. Whisper was flagged as a hero. And man, he is one. He's an Avenger.
That's huge. And now Chris Brown is ready to rock and roll. He's going to look to cut. It's not a lot.
Mm-hmm. It's more reliant on the synergy with CK to be the front line of 4 seconds of the stun. Soulbind as well as the silence.
Double
pulled them together, and with a double lasso, it's going to do work. But again, this fire strike in the back lines. But E-Home don't have to sustain the back into a three-man wall. My god, please. Someone give Whisper a very nice drink. He's earned it after this game one. Doom is down for a minute and a half. Neverend's going to join him as well.
Everyone.
He has buyback available, but no Exism. You're pop three, but can Ferrari 4-3-0 end up surviving? The Burrow Strike again, Zinq! My god, this guy! Such great stuns, but
so
you're
deep.
Not giving up. CK, way too deep. He'll consume the cheese. He's got more life, and here comes Wister. Search him out. The Burrow Strike's up, but he's been pulled. Reflect, he needs more time.
Oh,
so the
heart
can actually hit. He's going to get further away, create more space.
Oh,
up in the air, Whisper, he'll get silenced, but there's Lotus Orb trying to break free. SK's beginning his TP up, they really need to kill Whisper. Don't Burrow Strike him, you'll end up repositioning him back out again. He wants to search. Okay, now they do it, now that Lotus is gone.
Whisper is insane. So the mid lane.
Meepo running in close. They see Neverend, but the initiation's already happened on the Batrider. Get his BKB off now, but already down to so low life. Needs to get back behind the tower, but Stinger just doesn't have
no
the
movement
speed, and no buyback available.
Badly.
God. Meepo is just keeping E-Home's attention sideways. There's just silence in the back line. Singer jumps in. He gets a double lasso, pulling it back out. You don't need no axe when you got a Grimstroke. Just hold him in position in the wall again. E-Home cannot move further away. 4-3-0 gets himself a great stump of Faith Beyond. He cannot survive in the middle of all of this without buyback inside the Darkseid wall. E-Home, they just don't have enough life. Another great stun from Zinq. Create a little bit more space for Neverend to get the Spirit Siphon off. Now with the Epicenter, he'll get that out too, but held back the Earthbind. SK cannot get involved. They've got all the regeneration. Still fighting under the wall, but how many times does Zinq get himself a six-man stun? A couple of more. I'd like to see a couple run out, back, more space being created. Turner in, going back in for the stun, but again, Zinq. He just gets stun after stun after stun, but the bigger hero, K1 working together. Grimstroke will buyback be part of the party, but so long death time is for E-Home.
Yeah, no buybacks available. They're just going to potentially look for a throne here. Zinq doing his best. He's playing a game of his life, but it's just not going to matter. He's going to go down. No buyback. Go for throne here, right? E-Home?
Yeah. You're